Hello, in this video I will show you how I got strafing working in my game. For each side I use two animations, run while running forward and run while running backwards. So now he's strafing to the right and is running forward and now he runs backwards. For the left I have this as well, now he runs forwards and now again backwards. I will show how to make the animations and also how to set it up in your game. So I have all kinds of nodes, but for the walking and running we need a Blendspace 2D. At the insides are the nodes for walking, but for this video I will focus on the nodes for running, which are at the outside. The top and bottom nodes are just animations. But the ones left and right are your Blendspace 1D. If you select these, you can open them. Then you can also slide left and right to change the strafe animation. So now we're strafing by running backwards. If you go forward again, we can go until this point. If you go further, it will still work, but it looks a bit weird. But if you change the slider back, it will look a lot better. We now go first into Blender and create all the animations we need. So in total we need 8 animations. If you only get a run animation, that's not a problem, because I have made a video about how to convert a walk or run cycle into a strafe cycle. I will put a link for that in the description. So if you followed that tutorial, you should also have at least one strafe animation. We are now going to use the run forward animation to create the run backward animation. We need to be in pose mode. Select all bones and press new animation. Select all keyframes. Go to the middle keyframe and press S for scale and then -1. This will invert the animation. And now he runs backwards. But there is a problem. If we go to the first frame, we can see that he starts with his right leg going upwards. And he needs to start with his left leg. To fix this, move all keyframes to the left, so that the middle keyframe is on the first frame. Now delete the first keyframe, move these keyframes to the right, and copy the first keyframe to the last frame. And now if you look again, he starts with his left leg going upwards. Now we are going to use this animation to create the run left backward animation. Select the run left forward animation and press new animation. Select all keyframes and go to the first frame. Right click and press copy. Then right click again and press paste flipped. This will mirror the animation. To make him run backwards, do the same as before. Go to the middle keyframe and press S for scale and then -1. So now we have the animation we need. I will check if he starts with his left leg, and that looks all right. So now we also have this animation. We are now going to use this animation to create the run right forward animation. Select run left forward and press new animation. Select all keyframes and go to the first frame. Press copy and then paste flipped to mirror the animation. We need to make sure that he starts with his left leg. To do this, move all keyframes to the right so that the middle keyframe is on the last frame. Delete the last keyframe. Move these to the left. Copy the last keyframe to the first frame. And now he will start with his left leg. Now we're going to use the animation that we just created for the run right backward animation. Press new animation. Select all keyframes and go to the first frame. Press copy and paste flipped to mirror the animation. Go to the middle keyframe and press S for scale and then minus 1 to make him run backwards. He already starts with his left leg, so this one is also done. Now we need two more animations, and these are just for better blending. You need to create these from scratch, but they are very easy to make. Notice that in the same frame, if we compare the run left right forward animation with the run left right backward animation, the upper body moves in the opposite direction. Also, the arms move in the opposite direction. So, to make the blending as smooth as possible, in the hop animation, we mainly animate the legs and keep the upper body neutral. After you create the first hop animation, we can use it to make the other one. So, select the hop animation and press new animation. Select all keyframes and go to the first frame. Press copy and then paste flipped to mirror the animation. Now the animation does look a bit weird, and that's because of these white keyframes. Go to select and then invert. And now you can delete them. Make sure he starts with his left leg. To do this, move all keyframes to the right so that the middle keyframe is on the last frame. Delete this one. Move these to the left. And copy this one to the first frame. So now this one is also done. Now we have all the animations we need. You can also rename them if you need to. I will now show why we need that extra hop animation. If you delete it, the legs will cross to each other. At the outside it will still look good, but not in the center. So now I will undo that. It still does not look good, but that's because they are not synchronized. To fix that, you need to reload the project. And after that, it will be fixed. These two nodes are also a Blendspace 1D. And these are used for walking. In the center, I also have that hop animation for better blending. I will show a bit of my code. So we calculate the angle between the facing direction and the horizontal direction. We also compare the speed to the maximum speed. The faster we move, the more it goes to the outside. This way we know which animation should be used. For the strafing, we look if we are in the top area or in the bottom area. If we go beyond this point, we need to change the strafing to the run left backward animation. Now we can move it further down. If we want to go forward, we need to change it back to the run left forward animation. This way we get a very nice blending. So this is how my system works, and I hope that you find it useful.